So I think what makes the Jindal School really unique are five things. The first, I believe, is the question of interdisciplinarity. The built environment has always required people from all avenues to come together to process it. What we are able to do is actually create a curriculum that allows for cross-listing of courses. So students can take courses in the architecture school, they can take courses in the international affairs school, they can take a course in the public policy school, and they can take a course in the law school, thereby creating themselves as this unique professional. I think the second thing which is very, very unique about the Jindal School is the faculty. We have put together faculty who are from the best universities in the world. All of them, interestingly, have PhDs in a field which is other than architecture, right? So they have their undergraduate degrees in architecture, but actually, following this interdisciplinarity, they themselves are people who have crossed the traditional boundaries of architecture. The third way I think the Jindal School is very, very different is the idea of how we learn. Fundamentally, in this school, we believe that learning has to be embedded, it has to be contextual, and it has to come from what are called live projects. With actual live interventions in the city is how we are going to train our students to understand what are the problems that a city can come, right? So you act, you reflect on that action, and then you go back and act on it again. And knowledge production happens as a result of that. So it's not about students going for an internship later. They are interning while they are studying. In fact, their study is a form of internship. The fourth way I think the Jindal School is really, really unique is embedded in fundamentally becoming a school that is global in all its respects. To achieve this, we have tied up with some of the best schools of architecture and or built environment in the world. Cornell, UCL, Dundee, Adelaide, UNSW, University of Westminster, just to name a few of them. A further way in which we are doing international collaborations is actually having what we call faculty in residence to help our students get exposure to everything that is happening globally. In fact, we are becoming a part of what's called the Research Collective 21, which is the largest collection of architects, urban designers, sociologists who work on the built environment. The final way in which the school at Jindal is really unique, I think, is the way we are imagining our students. So the idea is not to train them as essentially becoming somebody who is constantly talking about development or change from top down, but rather how they can be agents of change along with people, involving different stakeholders. We in this country really need students who want to make this difference. And if you really want to do that, then this is definitely the place for you.